Hi everybody, today we're going to be making two Honeydukes inspired DIYs. The first tutorial I'm going to be showing you is how to make a Honeydukes inspired diorama. The first thing you want to do is measure the floor of your dollhouse, which you can find at a toy store or a thrift shop, and you want to measure the floor of it and then cut out a piece of printer paper to match and draw this checkerboard pattern all over it. Next, you want to take some dollhouse furniture, which you can find at a local craft store, and paint it with some light teal paint, which is the color of all the furniture at Honeydukes. Next, for the candy. For the Bott's Every Flavour beans, I took a plastic container and filled it with different multicolored little beads to represent the jelly beans. And I filled it with just different layers of different colors. On the smaller containers, I wrote out Bertie, Bott's beans with some permanent marker and decorated the outside. For some lollipops, I took some air dry clay and painted it with multicolored paint and then glued little pieces of spaghetti on for the handles. I also painted spaghetti with white and red to make little peppermint sticks. I then broke the pieces up and put them inside of little plastic bags, which originally held the beads. For chocolate frogs, I painted a piece of aluminum foil purple, put it inside of a plastic cap, and then filled it with some dark brown pieces of air dry clay. For the Honeydukes sign, I just painted a piece of hard plastic to look like the sign. I cut out some curtains out of mint green fabric to put inside of the little shop. I just placed them on the little curtain racks that were inside of the diorama. Next, I started placing all of my pieces of furniture, which I had added the candy to, inside of the shop. Once the shop was done, I decided to make some little Harry Potter characters to go along with it. I found these wooden dolls at my local craft store and then painted them with some acrylic paint to look like Harry, Ron, and Hermione. I finished them off with a little bit of clear glaze to give them a nice glossy finish. And there's the finished product of the Honeydukes diorama. I love how it turned out. The next DIY I'm going to be showing you how to make is a Bertie, Bott's Every Flavour Beans lantern. I started by just scoring some pieces of chipboard and measuring them out to be around 6 inches by 3 inches. And then I added the 3-inch triangular tops. I then cut them out with my scissors. Once it's all cut out, I scored the tops of the triangles so that they could fold over to create that nice box shape. I then started measuring out the windows. I did around 3-inch by 3-inch windows. Once I had measured out my windows, I cut them out. Now that the basic shape is done, We can start painting the whole piece white with some acrylic paint. After I finished painting it white, I started to paint red stripes down the entire piece to create those circus tent stripes. Once all the stripes are complete, we can start painting the little details onto the box. I started with painting the yellow pieces all around the different shaped windows. I just looked at a picture of the box to make sure that I was getting all the details just right. Next, I moved on to painting the black stripes down the sides of all of the yellow pieces. And I also started to paint out the writing that says Bertie, Bott, Every Flavour Beats. Once we're finished with all of the little details, we can start painting on the faces of the circus people. I just used tan acrylic paint and then added all of the little details on. Once again, I just looked at a picture of the box to make sure that I was getting everything just right with the details. Next, I just took some pieces of plastic that I had from some packaging and glued them on the inside of the box to create some windows. I also cut out and attached a bottom. Now to make it into an actual lantern, I put some stuffing inside to give it a little bit of height. I also put in a battery operated light and make sure it's battery operated and not real. This just adds a little bit of glow to the lantern. Finally, I just taped up the top of the box. I used tape so that you can open and close it, and I'm so happy with how this turned out. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you try these out yourself.